Okay, where signals are required? Kartik, why signals are required? Where signals are required?
To control traffic, sir.
To control the traffic, okay. Right. Suppose one straight road is there. Suppose road is there like this. Will you put signal here? Signal? Green signal, red signal, and you put and you stop the vehicles here?
At intersections.
Yeah. Signals are required at intersections, right? Signals are required at intersections. Intersection means, suppose a road is passing like this. Otherwise, I will draw like this. So this is intersection, right? So vehicles will be moving like this, and some vehicles will be moving in this way, and like this, okay. So to avoid accidents, okay, these are conflict points actually. To avoid accidents, sometimes vehicles may be moving free left also, right? Like this. And like this also, okay. Sometimes vehicles may need to go rightward direction, right turn, okay. That means like this, and finally like this. See, at a intersection, actually, vehicles may need to go either left or straight or right. So possibility is there, right? For every leg, the vehicle may want to go either left side or straightward direction or right side at a junction, right? So we cannot allow all of these movements at a time. So that means we need to split the movements. We need to split the movements, splitting of movements, okay? So some movements are allowing at a time. Suppose I will show you here. Straight, this straight, and this left going, and this left going can be allowed at a time, not a problem, right? They won't interrupt each other, okay? Straight going, both straight going and left going. Similarly, this way, and this way, and this left going vehicles and this left going vehicles can be allowed at a time. So four movements are allowing here. We are allowing four movements at a time. So let us assume it is phase one. What is meant by phase? Phase is nothing but in a given time, all those movements are allowing, okay? So these four movements are allowing in a phase. So in a phase, parallelly all these movements will be there. Let us assume this is phase two. Okay, what else are there? What else traffic is there? Straight going and left going over, right? Then right going. So right going, of course, you can put this and this in one phase and this and this in another phase, right? Phase three, phase four. For every leg, three kinds of movements are there. Left going, right going, straight going. So 3 × 4, 12 movements are there. Now, 12 movements are splitting into four phases actually. First phase, four movements. Second phase, four movements. Third phase, two movements. Fourth phase also, two movements. Clear under the name? Yala split chest na moments na netvi.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Suppose green light is there for phase one. Phase two, phase three, phase four will be having red light. After some time, phase two will get green light and phase one becomes red. Okay. After some time, phase three will get green time. Then phase two, it turns to red. Then finally, phase four will get a green time, green one, green light. Yeah, by the time all other signals will be having red signal only. So like that, one by one chances they will get, and that the complete everybody getting green time once means that is one cycle actually. So phase one gets green time, green light, then phase two gets green light, phase three, then phase four. So that is called one cycle actually. So what is the cycle length? How much time we need to allot for all to complete all these cycle phases? Okay, the cycle length we need to determine. Okay, and finally we need to split that cycle length into phases. Suppose phase one may needs more time compared to phase three. That depends on traffic of that moments. Okay, so suppose this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So 12 moments are there, right? 12 moments we are splitting into four phases. Suppose phase one. In phase one, 1, 2, 3, 4 moments are there. For 1, 2, 3, 4 moments, for which moment we need to allot? Otherwise, what is the critical lane? Suppose 9, 10. If you see, 9 may be having 50 vehicles. 10 may be having 60 vehicles. So we should allot time for 60 vehicles, whichever is more. Okay. So I will explain you what is critical lane and all in detail. So first of all, what is signal means? Why signals are required means? Where signals are required first? Answer for this is signals are required at intersections. Why signals are required? Why?
To avoid conflicts.
Conflicts and of course accidents, right? Okay, our main aim is to avoid accidents at conflict locations as well as to avoid jammed condition. Okay, if you don't have any signals like this, so finally the traffic may get jammed. Okay, so to avoid those situations we need to provide signals. Okay, so in these signals, what is meant by cycle length? Okay. Otherwise, before that, I will define what is a phase. What is meant by phase? Can you tell? Phase. Definition of phase. See, can you see what is the similarity? What is the commonality, common thing in phase, any phase, phase one, phase two, phase three, phase four? If you observe any phase here, the traffic moments are non-conflicting moments are there, right? See, 1, 2, 3, 4 here are non-conflicting. 5, 6, 7, 8 are non-conflicting. So phase is nothing but it consists of non-conflicting traffic moments allowing at a time at the intersection. Okay, so all these non-conflicting moments we are allowing at a time, that is called one phase. Okay, So like that, the totally we can split into either four phase signal or two phase signal, that is phase. So what is meant by cycle? Cycle means the time, I mean to complete all phases, I mean that is called cycle. Actually cycle consists of, it consists of all phases, okay, in a rotation basis. That means 1 2 3 4, again 1 2 3 4, again 1 2 3 4. Green time will be changing from one phase to another phase. If all phases covered, then that is one cycle. Okay, phase 1, phase 2, phase 3, phase 4 covered means then it is a cycle actually. So what is cycle length? Cycle length, to complete all phases, the time required, in seconds generally, okay, is called cycle length. Here cycle length means that is in seconds. It may be 60 seconds, it may be 70 seconds, something like that. If you go on road, actually you can observe, sometimes you may need to wait for 2 minutes. That means, so if you just miss the green signal just while going and at the intersection, just before turning the red, just you reach there and you stop your vehicle at the signal, then you need to wait for a cycle length, right? Again, when you will get turn after cycle length only, so you may need to wait for 2 minutes or 3 minutes. So that is the actually cycle length. Actually 3 minutes you are waiting means, that means the cycle length is 3 minutes. Just before reaching you there, you got the red signal, then again when you'll get green signal after cycle length, right? So that cycle length may be 2 minutes, 3 minutes, sometimes 40 seconds. It depends on the traffic and traffic volume, all those things, okay? So that will design everything, okay? So you understood what is phase, what is cycle, what is cycle length, right? Then what is meant by green interval? Green interval. See, any signal consists of green, red, and yellow. Right? Green, red, yellow. So what green indicates? Green indicates
allowing of vehicles.
Yeah, allowing the movement. Okay. Red means you need to stop. Okay. What about yellow? Suppose green is there, suddenly you have seen that yellow signal. What you will do after seeing yellow? Yellow means that is indicating that next red is coming. So suppose you are far away from signal, then you have to apply brakes and you have to stop before that stop line. Okay. you are far away, then you have to control the vehicle. That means you have to slow down the vehicle and you need to stop before stop line after seeing that yellow interval. Okay, yellow signal. Suppose you are very near to stop line, what you will do? You are very near to stop line and immediately have seen that yellow signal, then you have to increase your speed and you have to cross that junction as early as possible. Okay,
so break out.
Why break out? That okay, ipudu broken as was.
Okay sir.
Okay,
yes sir.
Okay, so why yellow interval is required means it is giving us some caution. Okay, so next red is coming, be alert. If you are very near to that stop line, you cannot stop the vehicle before stop line, then you have to accelerate the vehicle and you have to cross the junction. You are far away from stop line, then you have to apply brakes and you need to stop the vehicle before stop line. So that is one kind of caution it is giving in the form of yellow signal, right? Yellow interval. Not only that, even after red also, after red signal, immediately if you get yellow signal means what? What it indicates? After red signal, yellow signal is coming means, so you should be ready to stop. Sometimes, so you will stop the vehicle at signal, right? You will stop the vehicle at signal. So you need to again restart. So after red signal, if you get yellow signal, what you will do? You will start and you will be ready for moving. Okay. So then after turning that, green signal, turning to green signal, you will start the vehicle. So after red also sometimes you can expect that yellow signal. Otherwise, in majority of intersections after red, directly you will get green, right?
Yes, sir.
Hyderabad ela undi paristhiti? Red tarvata direct green vastunda yellow vastunda?
Green
vachestundi kada?
Yes, sir.
రెడ్ తర్వాత డైరెక్ట్ గ్రీన్ వచ్చేస్తుంది అనమాట, ఎటువంటి కాషన్ లేకుండా. సో పెడితే మంచిదే, అక్కడ కూడా ఎల్లో ఒక 2 సెకండ్స్ పెడితే కనుక మంచిదే అనమాట. సో అంటే స్టార్ట్ చేసుకోవడానికి ఛాన్స్ ఉంటుంది అన్నట్టు, టైం వేస్ట్ కాకుండా. ఇంకా అప్పుడు గ్రీన్ పడిన తర్వాత అప్పుడు కిక్ కొట్టుకుంటూ ఉంటారు చాలా మంది, మీరు గమనించవచ్చు. సో వేస్ట్ టైం వేస్ట్ అనమాట. ఆ గ్రీన్ బిఫోర్ కూడా ఒక 2 సెకండ్స్ కనుక ఎల్లో వచ్చినట్టయితే ఆ 2 సెకండ్స్లో వాళ్ళు ఆ ప్రయత్నం చేసి సో వెహికల్ రెడీ పెట్టుకుంటారు అనమాట. ఓకే, అదర్వైజ్ నో ప్రాబ్లం. ఓకే, సో గ్రీన్ రెడ్ ఎల్లో ఇంటర్వెల్స్. ఇంటర్వెల్స్ మీన్స్ హియర్ టైం గివెన్ టు ఎనీ ఫేజ్ ఫర్ వెహికల్ మూమెంట్. Okay, that is the green interval. Okay, red means time allotted to any phase for stopping the vehicles. Okay, stopping. Okay, in red interval the vehicles will be stopped. Okay, yellow means it is time given after green interval to alert the drivers to stop or proceed. Before coming the red signal. Okay. See, yellow interval, actually in yellow interval you can pause. If possibility is there, you can pause the junction. Okay. In yellow interval, if possibility is there, the driver can move through the junction and can cross the junction. If the driver is far away from junction, then he can safely stop the vehicle before stop line. Okay, that is the intention here, yellow signal, yellow interval. Okay, then what is meant by last time? Last, L-O-S-T, last time of phase. For any phase, what is the last time? To understand the last time, you have to observe the pattern at the vehicle pattern, vehicle speed patterns at the junction. Vehicle speed patterns at the junction. Okay, if you observe vehicle speed patterns, suppose this is the green time. I will explain you. Okay, suppose it is like this. What kind of speeds can you expect? Tell me. Speed pattern. Can you expect like this? At red, actually, no speed of the vehicles. Okay. As soon as signal turns to green, first vehicle cannot go with maximum speed. First vehicle moves slowly. Then if you observe the patterns of the speeds, it gradually increases. And after some time, it attains constant speed. Then, see here, up to this one, it go maximum speed and then suddenly it stops like this, right? So that means what happens here? This is speed actually. This is representing speed of the vehicles. Speed versus time. See, up to certain time, the vehicles are not moving with maximum speed. After some time, it is gaining maximum speed and the vehicles will go with maximum speed. After turning this yellow color, yellow signal, obviously, speed decreases again and comes to rest up by the time of getting red color. Meeku pattern ardhamainda? Meeru chuste first vehicle appude start chesukoni appudu pothadu anamata. Tarvata kaasep tarvata chuste junction lo anni full zooming speed tho pothuntayi tarvata. Kaasep tarvata. Signal padina ventane zooming speed tho vellalevu kada anni. Appude kadulutu untayi anamata. Ota 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 kadulutayi anamata. Meeku ardhamainda nenu em cheppal anukuntunnanu? Kirti clear amma?
Yes sir.
Okay. Now you will see that see speed is related, I mean speed and headways are related, right? What is time headway? Time headway is nothing but yeah, if you see that the headway is actually headway patterns. Headway versus time, if you observe, suppose more the speed, see, headway is what? Headway is time gap actually. Time gap means spacing between vehicles divided by velocity, right? Spacing between the vehicles divided by velocity. See, actually, velocity keep on increasing, obviously, headway keep on decreases. After some time, velocity becomes constant, gap becomes constant, obviously headway becomes constant. So headways, if you observe here, it will be like this. I'll explain you. Okay, that means starting more headway is required, ending also more headway is required. So that means the capacity of the road is less at the starting and ending. So more, suppose per second how many vehicles can go, suppose middle one, I mean at maximum speed per second, suppose 6 vehicles are going, starting per second maybe 2 vehicles only will go. Okay, that means some time we are losing actually. Some time, suppose meeku akada okay starting nundi kuda okay speed tho velthe manaku time anedi waste kaadu anamata. So because of this one, low speed at starting and ending or high headway at starting and ending, some time we are losing. So headway is actually time actually. So losing time is this one. I'll explain you here, losing time. See, suppose this one, this is losing time. Suppose this is 3 seconds. Suppose this is 1.1 second. This is 0.8 second. This is 0.1 second. Again here 0.1 second. So 0.9 seconds. So this is the losing time. Okay. So this is lost, actually lost time per phase is nothing but last time per phase. Okay. Okay. It is actually, it consists of at the starting of starting and ending of, at starting and ending of green time headways are more than normal, the sum of excess headway is called lost time, LOST. Okay, lost time of phase. Lost time of phase. మీకు అర్థమైంది కదా, ఆ ఎక్సెస్ నార్మల్ కంటే మనకు కాన్స్టెంట్ గా ఉండదు. ఎక్సెస్ ఏదైతే వస్తుందో హెడ్ వేస్, ఈచ్ వెహికల్ కి, ఈచ్ వెహికల్ కు ఉన్న హెడ్ వేస్ అన్నమాట, హెడ్ వే అన్నమాట, టైం హెడ్ వే. ఆ టైం మనం ఏమంటామంటే అంటే ఎక్కువ టైం తీసుకుంటుంది. సపోజ్ టు క్రాస్ ద, సపోజ్ దిస్ హైట్ ఈస్ సపోజ్ 2 seconds. To cross the junction, a vehicle needs to take only 2 seconds. But starting vehicle, it may take 3.1 seconds. Second vehicle may take 2.8 seconds. Third vehicle may take 2.1 seconds. Fourth vehicle 2 seconds. Fifth vehicle 2 seconds, and so on. So last vehicle is taking 2.9 seconds. Last before vehicle is taking 2.1 seconds. So those starting vehicles and ending vehicles are taking more time to cross the signal. That excess time is called lost time of that phase. Okay, the total sum of the excess time. Arthamaindi kada andarki? Aa signal daatadaniki patte time ni manamu headway antunnam anukunte kuda meeku clear ga artham aipothundi. So what is the lost time anedi? Starting and ending lo speeds takku untayi kabatti, okay, akkada automatic ga meeku టైం వేస్ట్ అవుతుంది అనమాట. ఆ స్పీడ్ కనుక ఒక్కసారిగా జూమింగ్ అయ్యేటట్టు ఉంటే, పికప్ బాగుండే వెహికల్స్ ఒక్కసారిగా స్పీడ్ పుంజుకునేటట్టు ఉంటే, ఆ లాస్ట్ టైం తక్కువ ఉంటుంది అనమాట. ఇట్ ఈస్ జనరలీ 2 to 3 seconds. ఓకే, 2 seconds కానీ 3 seconds కానీ ఉంటుంది అనమాట. ఏది పర్ ఫేజ్ కి లాస్ట్ టైం అనేది 2 to 3 seconds ఉంటుంది అనమాట. క్లియర్ కదా? దెన్
సరే, ఎండింగ్ లో ఇంకా స్పీడ్ గా వెళ్తారు కదా సార్?
ఎండింగ్ లో ఏమవుతుందంటే, కొంతమంది భయస్తులు, భయంగా ఉండే వాళ్ళు ముందుంటాడనమాట వాడు. వాడు వెళ్ళిపోవచ్చు యాక్చువల్ గా, కానీ వాడు తటపటాయిస్తుంటాడు, వెళ్ళిపోతామా లేదని స్లో డౌన్ చేస్తాడు అనమాట. వాడు స్లో డౌన్ చేయడం వల్ల వాడు వెళ్ళకుండా ఏం చేస్తాడు, వాడు కూడా ఆపాల్సి వస్తుంది అనమాట. బ్రేక్ బ్రేక్లు అప్లై చేయాల్సి ఉంటుంది అనమాట. బ్రేక్లు అప్లై చేసి వీడు పోకపోతే కూడా ఆ వెనకుండా వాడు కొంచెం స్లో డౌన్ చేసి వాడు వెళ్తాడు అనమాట. సమ్ డిస్టర్బెన్స్ అయితే వచ్చింది కదా వీడు బ్రేక్ లేయడం వల్ల. ముందుంటాడు బ్రేక్ లేయడం వల్ల వెనక వాళ్ళు కూడా సమ్ డిస్టర్బెన్స్ వచ్చేసి బ్రేక్ లేయాల్సి వస్తుంది అనమాట. ఆబ్వియస్లీ ఎక్కువ టైం పడుతుంది. వెళ్ళిపోయాడు వెళ్ళిపోతాడు, కానీ ఈ బ్రేక్ లేసి తటపటాయిస్తుంటారు కొంతమంది, అనుమానంగా చూస్తుంటారు అనమాట వెళ్ళగలమా లేదా అన్నట్టు. ముందే బ్రేక్ వేసి ఈ సిగ్నల్ ఎక్కడో ఉంటే కూడా అప్పుడే బ్రేక్ స్లో డౌన్ చేస్తారు, అమ్మో వెళ్తామో లేదో, మళ్ళీ ఫైన్ పడుతుందేమో, సిగ్నల్ జంప్ అంటారేమో అన్న భయంతో ఉంటారు కొంతమంది. వాళ్ళు ముందే ఆపేయాలని చూస్తారనమాట. వాళ్ళ వల్ల మిగతా వాళ్ళు డిస్టర్బెన్స్ వచ్చి ఇక్కడ టైం లూజ్ అవుతాం అనమాట. క్లియర్ కదా శ్రీనివాస్? అందరి సైకాలజీ ఒకే విధంగా ఉంటుంది అనమాట. కొంతమంది చాలా దగ్గరకు వచ్చినా కూడా, ఈవెన్ రెడ్ పడినా కూడా రెడ్ లో కూడా వెళ్ళే వాళ్ళు ఉంటారు ఒకరిద్దరు. లాస్ట్ మినిట్ లో కూడా, లాస్ట్ సెకండ్ లో కూడా ఆ పక్క ట్రాఫిక్ వచ్చేస్తుంటే కూడా వీడు పాస్ అవ్వాలని ట్రై చేస్తారనమాట. ఒక్కొక్కసారి యాక్సిడెంట్స్ కూడా జరుగుతుంటాయి మనకు, చూస్తుంటాం మనం. కాకపోతే అటువైపు నుండి వచ్చేవాడు కూడా గమనిస్తుంటాడు కాబట్టి వీడిని, వీడు వెళ్ళి కుదరదు కదా, వాడు వస్తున్నాడని వీడికి తెలుస్తుంటుంది. సో వీడి ఇంకా ఓపికతో వెయిట్ చేయాల్సి ఉంటుంది అనమాట. అదర్ అదర్ మూమెంట్ వాడు, అదర్ ఫేజ్ వాడు కదా. వీడికి గ్రీన్ పడి, వీడికి గ్రీన్ పడి వాడికి రెడ్ పడి ఉంటే కూడా వాడు రెడ్ లో కూడా పోతుంటాడు ఇంకా ఆగకుండా. వీడు మాత్రం ఆ పిచ్చోళ్ళు లెక్కన వెయిట్ చేస్తూ ఉండాల. కొంతమంది ర్యాష్ గా ఉండాలి అయితే దూరేస్తారనమాట, ఏదైనా నువ్వెందుకు వస్తావు అన్నట్టు వీడు దూరేస్తుంటాడు అనమాట. సో అప్పుడు యాక్సిడెంట్ జరిగే ఛాన్స్ ఉంటుంది. సో ఇదంతా సైకాలజీ పైన డిపెండ్ అయి ఉంటుంది, డ్రైవర్ సైకాలజీ. అక్కడ వాళ్ళు కొంతమంది చాలా భయస్తులు ఉంటారు, కొంతమంది చాలా రెక్లెస్ గా డ్రైవ్ చేసే వాళ్ళు ఉంటారు. సో దానివల్ల ఓవరాల్ గా మనకి అక్కడ డిస్టర్బెన్స్ అనేది స్టార్టింగ్ లో ఎట్లా డిస్టర్బెన్స్ ఉంటుందో, ఎండింగ్ లో కూడా సమ్ డిస్టర్బెన్స్ ఉంటుంది. సో దానివల్ల మనకి టైం లూజ్ అవుతుంది, అది లాస్ట్ టైం అనమాట. సో దెన్ వాట్ ఈస్ ద టోటల్ లాస్ట్ టైం ఆఫ్ సైకిల్? టోటల్ లాస్ట్ టైం ఆఫ్ సైకిల్ ఇట్ ఈస్ రిప్రజెంటెడ్ బై ఎల్. యాక్చువల్లీ ఇట్ ఈస్ సమ్ ఆఫ్ లాస్ట్ టైం ఆఫ్ ఆల్ ఫేసెస్. లాస్ట్ టైం ఆఫ్ ఆల్ ఫేజెస్ దట్ ఇస్ ద టోటల్ లాస్ట్ టైం ఆఫ్ సైకిల్. ఓకే, నెక్స్ట్ వాట్ ఈస్ మీన్ బై ఎఫెక్టివ్ గ్రీన్ టైం? ఎఫెక్టివ్ గ్రీన్ టైం ఆఫ్ ఎ ఫేజ్. ఓకే, ఎఫెక్టివ్ గ్రీన్ టైం ఆఫ్ ఫేజ్, యాక్చువల్లీ క్యాపిటల్ జిఐ, స్మాల్ జిఐ. సి యాక్చువల్ గ్రీన్ టైం ఈస్ డిఫరెంట్. యాక్చువల్ గ్రీన్ టైం ప్లస్ ఎల్లో టైం. సో యు కెన్ అబ్జర్వ్ దాట్ ఇన్ ఎల్లో టైం ఆల్సో వెహికల్ కెన్ మూవ్, రైట్? ఇన్ ఎల్లో టైం ఆల్సో వెహికల్స్ కెన్ మూవ్. గ్రీన్ టైం యాజ్ వెల్ యాజ్ ఎల్లో టైం వెహికల్స్ కెన్ పాస్, మైనస్ లాస్ట్ టైం. లాస్ట్ టైం ఆఫ్ ఫేజ్. సో యాక్చువల్ గ్రీన్ టైం, యాక్చువల్ ఎల్లో టైం మైనస్ లాస్ట్ టైం ఆఫ్ దట్ ఫేజ్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ ఎఫెక్టివ్ గ్రీన్ టైం, వేర్ జిఐ ఈక్వల్ టు యాక్చువల్ గ్రీన్ టైం ఆఫ్ యాక్చువల్ గ్రీన్ టైం ఆఫ్ ఫేజ్ ఐ. ఓకే, సిమిలర్లీ ఎల్లో టైం ఆఫ్ ఫేజ్ ఐ, పిఎల్ఐ ఈజ్ నథింగ్ బట్ లాస్ట్ టైం, లాస్ట్ టైం ఆఫ్ ఐత్ ఫేజ్. దట్ ఈస్ ద ఎఫెక్టివ్ గ్రీన్ టైం ఆఫ్ దట్ ఫేజ్. ఓకే, దెన్ వాట్ ఈస్ మీన్ బై క్రిటికల్ లేన్? క్రిటికల్ లేన్ వాట్ ఈస్ మీన్ బై క్రిటికల్ లేన్? సపోజ్ ఇన్ ఫేజ్ వన్ దీస్ టూ మూమెంట్స్ ఆర్ అలౌడ్. సపోజ్ ఫేజ్ వన్, దట్ ఈస్ సపోజ్ జంక్షన్ ఈస్ దేర్ లైక్ దిస్, Suppose these and these are allowed. These both are non-conflicting, right? Suppose here 200 vehicles per hour are moving. Here only 180 vehicles per hour are moving. So we need to design the signal for 200, right? That phase needs to be designed for maximum of these two. So in a phase, actually in a given phase, maximum number of vehicles occupying that in a given lane is called critical lane. Okay, critical lane is nothing but in a given phase, maximum number of vehicles passing lane is called a critical lane. Okay, so in one particular lane, maximum number of vehicles will be going out of compared to that other one. Okay, suppose you have 200 180, then suppose this is lane 1, this is lane 2. So which is critical lane here? Here critical lane is lane 1. Lane 1 is critical lane. That means we need to design the signal for critical lane volume only. So for here, critical lane volume, the volume of vehicles per hour in critical lane is called critical lane volume. So for critical lane volume, we need to design the signal. Okay, critical lane volume. Next, saturation flow rate of a lane. Of any lane, how to find what is the saturation flow rate means? See, saturation flow rate means if signal is green, for 1 hour, and vehicles on the road, are many. That means infinity. Suppose theoretically, infinity. That means continuously vehicles are coming on the road. Okay. If vehicles on the road are infinity, number of vehicles are there on the road, then maximum number of vehicles can pass through the junction per hour is called saturation flow rate of the lane. Okay. మీకు అర్థమైంది కదా? ఎప్పుడు గ్రీన్ లైట్ పెట్టేయండి ఒక ఒక పర్టికులర్ రోడ్కి, ఒక లేన్కి గ్రీన్ లైట్ ఉంటే పోతూనే ఉంటాయి కదా వెహికల్స్. అంటే కంటిన్యూస్గా 1 అవర్ పంపించండి. మీకు వెహికల్స్ కొదవలేదు, వెనక చాలా ఉన్నాయి క్యూలో, చాలా పెద్ద క్యూ ఉంది, పోతూనే ఉన్నాయన్నమాట 1 అవర్ వరకు. ఆ 1 అవర్లో ఎన్ని వెహికల్స్ పాస్ అవ్వగలుగుతాయి అనేది సాచురేషన్ ఫ్లో రేట్. అఫ్కోర్స్ ఇట్ డిపెండ్స్ ఆన్ రోడ్ కండిషన్స్, దట్ గ్రేడియంట్, వాట్ ఎవర్ దట్ లొకాలిటీ, ఆల్ దోస్ థింగ్స్ ఓకే ఇన్ఫ్లుయెన్స్ ద saturation flow rate capacity. Okay, so saturation flow rate in a lane is nothing but maximum number of vehicles can pass through the junction per hour. Okay, it is saturation flow rate. Clear andariki ippudu varaku? Doubts emana unnaya?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Clear, sir.
Okay, then next very important thing is critical flow ratio. One second. Critical flow ratio. Suppose it is yi. It is nothing but critical lane volume. Critical lane volume per hour, of course, per hour divided by saturation flow rate of that lane. Saturation flow rate of lane is called critical flow ratio, yi. Okay, critical flow ratio. Having all these things, you can design the cycle length. Okay, now finally see Webster. According to Webster, optimum cycle length. Webster optimum cycle length. Okay. CO. Okay. We need to define this. See what happens. Cycle length. Suppose small cycle length if you put, what happens? Big cycle length if you put, what happens? Suppose cycle length is only 30 seconds. What happens? Only 30 seconds means, see, starting loss, ending losses are there. So losses will be much more actually. Losses will be much more if cycle length is very small, losses will be much more. Suppose cycle length is very big. Suppose you will put cycle length of 10 or 15 minutes. What happens? What is the problem? If you put more cycle length, what happens? If you put more cycle length, very big queues will form on the road. Okay. Be very big queues and total delay will be much more. So cycle length cannot be very small and cannot be very big. So optimum cycle length should be there. How to find that optimum cycle length? So that is very important. So Webster, from experiments, okay, empirically he proposed one formula, that is optimum cycle length C naught equal to, it's very important for gate actually, 1.5 times of L plus 5 divided by 1 minus sigma of yi. Sigma means sum of all phases, okay? Yi, you know, critical flow ratio. Sum of the critical flow ratios is nothing but, suppose 4 phase signal means y1, y2, y3, y4, we need to add y1 plus y2 plus y3 plus y4. Like that, okay. Suppose two phase signal means y1 plus y2, that is sigma. L is the total loss time for all phases. 1.5 L plus 5 divided by 1 minus sigma yi is the optimum cycle length. This is cycle length in seconds actually. Webster proposed this. So clear a formula?
Yes, sir.
Sir, L total loss, sir. L total loss, sir.
Yeah, well, where L equal to total loss time for all phases. Total loss time for all phases. Sigma yi is nothing but sum of critical flow ratios of all phases. 2006 లో నాకు ఆల్ ఇండియా ఫోర్త్ ర్యాంక్ వచ్చినప్పుడు ఈ ఒక్క ఫార్ములా నాకు గుర్తు ఉండుంటే ఫస్ట్ ర్యాంక్ వచ్చింటుంది అనమాట. ఇది నాకు గుర్తులేదు, ముందు రోజు వరకు చదివాను, కానీ ఆ ఎగ్జామ్లోకి వెళ్ళిన తర్వాత ఈ ఫార్ములా మర్చిపోయా. అంటే మెమరీ ఎలా ఉంటుంది అనేది మీకు ఎగ్జాంపుల్ కోసం చెప్పాను. మనకు మెమరీ ఎలా ఉంటుందంటే అంతా గుర్తున్నట్టే ఉంటుంది, ఎగ్జామ్ సెంటర్లో కన్ఫ్యూజ్ అయిపోయి అది 5 L 1.5 L + 5 ఉందా, 1.5 ఉందా, కింద మైనస్ ఉందా, ప్లస్ ఉందా, ఇలాంటి మర్చిపోతూ ఉంటాం జనరల్గా. ఎందుకంటే చాలా విషయాలు మనం గుర్తుపెట్టుకోవాలి కదా, సుమారు ఒక 2000-3000 ఫార్ములాస్ ఉంటాయి కదా, ఓవరాల్ గా అన్ని గుర్తుండవు అనమాట. సో మనం అప్పుడప్పుడు ఫ్రీక్వెంట్ గా చూస్తూ ఉంటే గుర్తుంటాయి తప్ప, మనం ఏదో ఈరోజు చూసేసి ఇంకొక 2-3 మంత్స్ వదిలేస్తే మళ్ళీ గుర్తుండవు. ఈ ఫార్ములా గుర్తు లేకపోతే ఏమవుతుంది, మనకు మార్క్ రాదు ఇంకంతే. అఫ్ కోర్స్ మల్టిపుల్ చాయిస్ మనకు మ్యాచ్ కాలేదు, మళ్ళీ ఇంకో 2-3 ట్రై చేయొచ్చు, కానీ ఏమాత్రం ఐడియా రాలేదన్నమాట. సింపుల్ ఫార్ములా బట్ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఇది. యాక్చువల్గా మనకు గేట్లో చాలా సార్లు రిపీట్ అయింది అనమాట ఈ ఈ క్వశ్చన్, వెబ్సర్ ఆప్టిమమ్ సైకిల్ లెంత్. ఓకే, సో నౌ యు సీ సమ్ ప్రాబ్లమ్. ఓకే, వన్ మోర్ థింగ్, గ్రీన్ స్ప్లిట్టింగ్. See, optimum cycle length, that cycle length we need to divide the green time for all phases, right? How to split that green time to all phases? So splitting of green time for all phases, it is based on critical flow ratio. Okay, that means proportional to the in that ratio, it must be proportional to the critical flow ratio. That is, actually suppose total effective green time, total effective green time is cycle length minus total lost time. Okay, optimum cycle length minus total lost time is the total effective green time. Okay, then we need to split that into critical flow ratios, right? That means, what is that critical flow ratio symbol sign? Yi. Okay, y1 is to y2 is to, suppose y3 must be equal to g1 is to g2 is to g3, something like this. Okay, proportional, that must be proportional to this one. Okay, green times are proportional to critical flow ratios, right? That means, suppose g1 if you want to find, or gi if you want to find, that is yi divided by sigma yi into C0 minus L. This C0 minus L needs to be split for phase I in the ratio of that yi divided by sigma yi. Okay, that means g1 equal to y1 by y1 plus y2 plus and so on into C0 minus L. Similarly, g2 equal to y2 by y1 plus y2 plus and so on C0 minus L. So this is the effective green time. So G1, G2 are effective green times, right? So we need to split the total green time, total effective green time, C0 minus L, in that ratios. Finally, if you see G1 plus G2 plus and so on, if you see, it will be obviously equal to C0 minus L. Okay? C0 minus L, that effect, total effective green time. C0 minus L is the total effective green time. క్లియర్ అయ్యి వరకు ఏం డౌట్ లేవు కదా. ఓకే, సో గ్రీన్ స్ప్లిట్టింగ్ కూడా అర్థమైపోయింది మీకు. One final thing is here. That is optimum cycle length. Minimum cycle length concept also I will explain you. So till now they never asked in gate exam, but we will see that also. Minimum cycle length, that is C minimum. The logic behind this is very simple. Assume C is the cycle length. C is the cycle length. Number of cycles per hour? Karthik, number of cycles per hour, how much? Srinivas, number of cycles per hour? Cycle length in seconds. So C is the cycle length in seconds, then number of cycles per hour?
3600 by C.
Yeah, 3600 seconds per hour by C is the number of cycles per hour. Then total last time per hour. Let last time per cycle is L. Last time per cycle. That means total last time per cycle. Okay. I will mention the total word. Let total last time of all phases per cycle equal to L. Okay. Then total last time per hour. Total last time per hour equal to how much? See, per cycle is L. How many number of cycles are there? 3600 by C. Okay. Total cycles are 3600 by C. Per cycle loss is L. Then for all cycles of that, okay, 3600 by C, how much loss will be there? Loss will be there. Nitish? Enta Nitish?
Sir.
Enta? Ardham avutunda? Total number of cycles 3600 by C anamata. Oka cycle ki loss vachi L aithe, anni cycles loss enta? Oka cycle loss L. ఎన్ని సైకిల్స్ ఉన్నాయి ఎవరికి?
3600 బై సి.
అప్పుడు టోటల్ లాస్ ఎంత?
3600 ఎల్ బై సి
ఇంటూ ఎల్ అంతేనా?
ఎల్ బై సి.
ఎందుకంటే నంబర్ ఆఫ్ ఇవి నంబర్ ఆఫ్ సైకిల్స్ ఒక సైకిల్ లాస్ టోటల్ లాస్ పర్ అవర్ అన్నమాట. సో ఇంత లాస్ అయిపోతే ఎఫెక్టివ్ గ్రీన్ టైం available per hour, suppose that is TZ equal to effective time available. Totally 3600 seconds will be there, minus how many seconds we are losing totally? 3600 by C into L. So this much we are losing. So total available is now 3600 minus that one, right? Clear akadiki? That is 3600 multiplied by 1 minus L by C. Okay, that is TZ, total green time. Okay, then assume sum of critical lane volumes per hour equal to V. That means suppose lane 1, lane 2, lane 3, lane 4, all lanes together per hour, how many vehicles are going through the critical lanes? Let us assume that is V. Then that V must be equal to, see here, TZ by H, right? H is nothing but headway. I mean, time required for each vehicle. So total time available is TZ. Okay, total available green time is TZ, where H is time headway. Okay, so you can substitute in place of TZ, TZ equal to V into H. So substituting there, V into H equal to 3600 into 1 minus L by C, right? Okay, from this, I'll write next page. V into H equal to 3600 into 1 minus L by C, or V equal to 3600 by H, 1 minus L by C. Here basically the saturation flow rate, whatever is there here, saturation flow rate is nothing but here saturation flow rate, SI, here I will write saturation flow rate of ith phase equal to 3600 by H. Okay, H means headway. Per hour, 3600 seconds will be there. To pass each vehicle, suppose H seconds are required, then how many vehicles can go in 1 hour? 3600 by H, that is saturation flow rate. So here also, that's 3600 by H can be represented by saturation flow rate. Saturation flow rate of ith phase, okay? 1 minus L by C. Okay. Then from this C equal to C, we can see, actually this one is total. V by SI equal to 1 minus L by C, or L by C equal to 1 minus V by SI, or C equal to L by 1 minus V by SI. So where, what is V here? Sum of all critical and volumes, right? V equal to sum of all critical lane volumes, that equal to sigma of Vi, sigma of Vi. So V by SI can be represented like this, Vi by SI, or that equal to V1 by, actually assuming all lanes having same saturation, V1 by S1 plus V2 by S2, something like this, or sigma of Vi by SI. See, Vi by SI is nothing but Yi, that is critical flow ratio. Critical flow ratio, okay, sigma of Yi. So C minimum, actually this is C minimum equal to total last time divided by 1 minus sigma Yi. So this is the minimum last time. Okay. Formula for minimum last time. Adhana kada? Clear andariki?
Sir, sum of critical lane volumes per hour, V equal to G by H.
Sum of critical lane volumes
per hour, V is equal to TG by H.
See here, TG by H means, see, TG is a total green time available per hour. Okay, green time in seconds. This is in seconds. TG is in seconds. H is per vehicle how much green time is required? Per vehicle how much green time is required is H. So TG is total green time available. So total, suppose TG is suppose 1800 seconds. H is 2 seconds. So each vehicle requires 2 seconds to pass. Then 1800 seconds divided by 2 seconds, you will have 900 numbers, right? So 900 vehicles can go through the signal in green time. That's why this is, that is sum of critical and volumes. Okay, volume is here number, number of vehicles. Okay, number of vehicles.
Yes, clear.
Time out divided by time, adi numbers vachustundi. So now we'll see some problems on this. So Webster only important for us, nothing to worry about this C minimum. See the 462 problem. Problem number 462. That is GATE 2016. Okay. Otherwise, you see first. Problem number 485. Open chain nadru. సాఫ్ట్ కాపీ ఉంటే సాఫ్ట్ కాపీ ఓపెన్ చేయండి, లేకపోతే బుక్ ఉంటే బుక్ ఓపెన్ చేయండి. ఫర్ డిజైనింగ్ ఏ టూ ఫేజ్ ఫిక్స్డ్ టైప్ సిగ్నల్ అట్ అన్ ఇంటర్సెక్షన్ హ్యావింగ్ నార్త్ సౌత్ ఈస్ట్ వెస్ట్ రోడ్ వేర్ ఓన్లీ స్ట్రైట్ అహెడ్ ట్రాఫిక్ పర్మిటెడ్, ద ఫాలోయింగ్ డేటా ఈస్ అవైలబుల్. ఓకే, పారామీటర్ డిజైన్ అవర్, పారామీటర్ డిజైన్ అవర్ ఫ్లో, సాచురేషన్ ఫ్లో నార్త్ సౌత్ ఈస్ట్ వెస్ట్. So in north-south direction, if you see, saturation flow rate is constant, 2500. Flow is 1000 to 700. So what is Y1? Y1 equal to what is critical lane out of this north and south?
North
is here. North is critical lane. So critical lane flow by saturated flow, saturation flow. So that is the Y1. Critical flow ratio, Y1 is called critical flow ratio of phase 1, which is equal to how much? 0.4. Similarly, Y2 how much? Second phase, east to west. So east 900 to west 550. Saturation flow 3000. So critical lane is 900, whichever is maximum. 900 by 3000, how much?
0.3.
0.3. So sigma yi is how much? 0.4 plus 0.3, that equal to 0.7. okay, so he mentioned here total loss time for cyclist 12 seconds. He has given directly L equal to 12 seconds given. Kirti chustunnaru ma book?
Yes sir.
So ఎవరి దగ్గర మెటీరియల్ లేదు చెప్పండి. మల్లికార్జున్, హావ్ యు టేకెన్ మెటీరియల్?
నో సార్, సాఫ్ట్ కాపీ.
ఎందుకు తీసుకోలేదు? నేను చెప్పాను కదా అవైలబిలిటీ ఉంది హైదరాబాద్ లో పెట్టామని.
వెళ్ళలేదు సార్, వీలుంటే వెళ్తాను.
నువ్వు బయట ఉన్నావా, హైదరాబాద్ లో లేవా?
లేదు సార్, బాసర్ లో ఉన్నా సార్, ఇంటి దగ్గర.
ఇంటి దగ్గర ఉన్నా. ఓకే ఓకే. సో ఎల్ ఈక్వల్ 12 సెకండ్స్ హియర్. Then optimum cycle length formula you can apply. 1.5 L plus 5 divided by 1 minus sigma yi. That is 1.5 into 12 plus 5 divided by 1 minus 0.7, which is equal to 76.67. So rounding to integer, that is 77 seconds. Okay. Like that. Then you can see similar problem 487. IFS problem. 487 IFS. Okay. A fixed time two phase signal is to be designed for four legged intersection, for which the design hourly flow, saturation flow are given below. Details of flow, design hourly flow, saturation flow, north to south, east to west. So what is Y1? Y1 equal to max of max of, see, saturation flow rates are different here. So we need to be careful, okay? 570 by 1750, comma 320 by 1500. Max of, maximum we need to take, the ratio. The ratio, maximum we need to take. In previous problem, saturation flow of north and south was same, east and west was same. Then directly you can choose the maximum flow, but here the ratio maximum we need to take, okay? Ratio of maximum, okay? 570 by 1750, 320 by 1500. What is the maximum of this thing?
0.33.
Tell me, what is 570 by 1750? The max of 0.326, comma 320 by 1500.
0.13.
That equal to 0.326 is the maximum. Similarly, Y2 equal to max of 550 by 2210, comma 455 by 2265. Okay. Equal to how much?
0.25.
Okay. So then last time is total last time per phase due to starting delays is 2 seconds. Okay. So per phase is 2 seconds. How many phases are there? 2 phases. Per phase 2 seconds. So total last time is 4 seconds. Okay. So optimum cycle length how much? C naught equal to 1.5 into L plus 5 divided by 1 minus 0.226 plus 0.25, which is equal to
25.96 seconds,
right? He is asking allocate the green time for 2 phases using Webster method. Allocation also, green splitting also. So what is G1? G1 equal to Y1 by Y1 plus Y2 into C0 minus L, which is equal to Y1 is 0.326 by 0.326 plus 0.25 into C0, 26 minus L is 4. How much?
12.5 seconds.
Okay. G2 equal to Y2 by Y1 plus Y2 into C0 minus L. 0.25 by 0.236 plus 326 plus 0.25 into 26 minus 4. Which is equal to
9.5 seconds.
Okay, these are the green allocation. So actual green time also, suppose actual green times, if you want to find, suppose capital Y1 equal to 2 seconds, capital Y2 equal to 2 seconds. Y means yellow time here. Okay, yellow times. So formula of G1 equal to capital G1 plus capital Y1 minus last time PL1. Okay. So here G1 12.5 seconds equal to capital G1 plus yellow time 2 seconds minus last time 2 seconds, that phase. Okay. So G1 equal to 12.5 seconds. Similarly, G2 equal to capital G2 plus Y2 minus PL2. So here 9.5 equal to G2 plus Y2 is 2 seconds. We are assuming here PL2 2 seconds. So G2 also now here 9.5 seconds. Capital G means actual green time. Actual green time is different. Effective green time is different. Okay. Clear? Can see some other problems. Okay, you complete all these problems from 462 onwards. From 462 to 462 to 506. Okay. చేస్తారా 506 వరకు చేసేసేయండి మొత్తం చాప్టర్ అంతా కంప్లీట్ చేయండి చాప్టర్ 6 ఏం డౌట్స్ లేవు కదా